And we are underway once again in the Seating 92.9 big room. So happy to be joined today by Cannons. Thanks so much for being here. Why don't we start off with a song and then we'll go from there.
All right, this one's Talk Talk.
Amazing. It's Cannons with us in the CD90 29 Big Room. Thanks again. That sounds great. My word.
Thank you.
So happy to have you here in the Big Room in person. The last time that we spoke, it was almost exactly a year ago over Instagram. And I think the most recent buzz at that time was that guy Dogface. You remember him?
Oh, yeah.
On the skateboard.
Yeah, he was skating to Fire For You in Caesar's Palace.
Yeah, drinking his cranberry sauce, cranberry juice.
Juice, yes.
And how times have changed since then.
Yes.
You've got a couple new singles that are out now. You've been on the road for a little bit now. How does it feel to have that kind of a year and to be back out and get into things in real life?
Feels really good. We've been having a fun time, and it is great to get out there and actually meet people in person that we've spoken to, like a year ago. And we've done a lot of Zooming, even with our main team and stuff. So it's good to see people face to face, get to play shows in real life, and It's been awesome.
Yeah, gosh, it's got to be so exciting. And what a year that it's been for you. Fire for You, the smash hit single that launched you into the mainstream after the Netflix series picked it up, Never Have I Ever. And that was early pandemic, if I'm not mistaken. Did you expect the success to last as long as it has?
We had no idea, but it's been like a very like consistent climb for a really long time, and we're super grateful.
Yeah, I'm always curious when that sort of stuff happens, when you send a song off to Netflix and they say, hey, can we have Fire For You and use it in our song or in our show? Do they tell you that it's going to be used in like the most important part of the show?
It was a complete surprise. I don't even think we knew that it was going to be on that show to begin with. We started getting like all these notifications from people on Instagram and Twitter telling us about the show and the positioning of the song.
Yeah, well, I can't even imagine what that must feel like for you. And it shot up to number one on the Billboard charts. And again, the rest is history. Then follow-up to Fire For You is Bad Dream, another song that we're spinning here at CD92.9. And I understand that was the second song that you wrote during the pandemic. How did that come together? What kind of headspace were you in?
We were all working from our own quarantine spots during that time. So I believe, did you start the bones to the song, and then I did some vocal stuff, and then Paul.
Yeah, gosh, well, it sounds great. One of my favorite songs that we're playing here at CD92.9, again, Bad Dream from Cannons, and I understand we'll hear it today. Is that true?
Yeah, we got that up next.
Awesome. Well, go ahead and take it away. It's Cannons in the CD92.9 Big Room.
Thank you.
you. It's Bad Dream from Cannons, performed here live in the CD90 29 Big Room. As we stand here on this Friday, November 26th, it's a date on the calendar that within the Big Room canon, pun intended, there haven't been that many performances on this date. In fact, in hundreds of appearances from bands over the years, this is the second time that we've had a show on November 26th. I think it has a lot to do with the season. In fact, here we stand the day after Thanksgiving. I got to ask, did you get up to anything fun yesterday?
We did a lot. We did some driving yesterday, and then we had Thanksgiving at Cracker Barrel.
Oh, that's a very Midwest way to celebrate. That's awesome.
Yeah, it was good. It is Thanksgiving special.
That's great. Well, thankful for your appearance here today. And I want to walk it back to some music that you released a little bit earlier this year. You opened this Big Room performance with your song called Talk Talk. And I remember when I pressed play on it for the first time, I thought, there's no way this is a cover of Talk Talk by the band Talk Talk. And it wasn't. It's very much your own song. But you're no stranger to covers, releasing an EP earlier this year, aptly called Covers by Cannons, the EP. And I want to ask about how it kind of came together, because there's five tracks on it, and it's such a wide range of styles. Harry Styles is on it, Kings of Leon, the Isley Brothers, The Neighborhood, and Bruce Springsteen. How did it come together? Is that like each of you brings a song to the table, or y'all kind of thought about it?
Well, since we were stuck inside for quite some time over quarantine, we decided to connect with the audience, our fans and stuff, by releasing some cover videos, because we also had been working on our album and couldn't release those songs yet. So we're like, let's just do some covers for fun and release those. And whatever we were listening to at the time, we and that we all liked, we just decided to make a Cannons version of.
Nice. Yeah, they all sound great. And you can find them online wherever you get your music. Again, the Covers by Cannons EP. Is there any cover that you kind of worked through in your head and maybe you brought to the table and everybody else was like, oh, no, we shouldn't do that one? Anything that got left on the cutting room floor?
Heartbeats by The Knife.
Oh, wow.
It sounded really good. I don't know what happened. We just started probably working on a song for our album, and then we need to go back to that.
Yeah, gosh, that's a really cool deep cut. I've got my fingers crossed for that one in the future, to be sure. But it's not the only music that you've released so far this year. I want to ask about the single called Ruthless that is out now. It is a kind of a scathing kind of breakup song, which surprised me as subject matter because, I mean, just from my perspective, you got it going on this year. Congrats to Michelle on getting engaged this year. Give it up for that.
Thank you.
And Ryan also got married this year. Congratulations on that.
Thank you so much.
But in the face of all this, the song comes out, and there's a lot of FUs within the lyrics and a lot of anger. Where, can I ask, does the emotion come from?
Honestly, while I was writing that song, someone really close to me was going through a really bad breakup, and I'm just a very empathetic person, so I don't like people hurting my friends or my family, so that song kind of was for them, because when you're going through heartbreak, sometimes you just have to let out those really nasty emotions and you feel better after. So it's just kind of to help someone out.
That's great. A very empathetic and a very strong defense. Again, that new single Ruthless out now. Well, I don't think we can play it here, but I understand we have a smash hit coming next. One last thing before we get to that, I do want to run you through a quick lightning round if you're up for it. Dogs or cats?
Dogs.
If there's a listener out there who just got a dog and hasn't yet named that dog, what should they name the dog?
Jerry.
I love a good person name for a dog. That's great. Coffee or tea?
Tea.
And lastly, I like to ask everybody that comes through this question, I'm working on a map. What is the prettiest American state in terms of its geographical outline alone?
Ooh. Ohio.
There we go.
Yeah.
Great answer. Love to hear it. Once again, it's Cannons with us in the CD90-29 Big Room.
This is Fire for You.
Where did you go? I could
Amazing. Thanks again for swinging through the big room today. It's so nice to see you.
Thanks so much for having us.
And we'll send you back down to Control Central.